Waste Management.
All right, just as it relates to staff, I'd love to see that report if it's possible, just to forward it. Great presentation. It sounds like you're doing a good job, but that's obviously something that I would encourage if there's a way. And I understand trash from here goes to Johnson Canyon and Gonzales, whereas within, so to speak, the same sphere of influence, trash is going to Marina, and Marina's a lot closer. Is that?
No. This from Madison Lane to Monterey Regional, or from Salinas to Johnson Canyon. It's just a few minutes difference.
Okay. One other quick question. So you went through that slide with all the different percentages of where folks are coming from. How about from out of the area? Do we have a lot of tourists, or not tourists, but folks coming to dump their trash in exotic locations?
We have very few customers. The vast majority of our customers come from Salinas. We do have a few customers that come from North County, but Waste Management wants to move more towards large volume generators, so they're changing the rates to encourage small generators, self-haul, to come to Sun Street. So that's where we have seen an increase.
And
it's minor.
Is Madison Lane viewed as almost like the competition? Like, the reason why I was startled to see such a low percentage from, say, Councilwoman Craig's district, are they all going to Baranda? I mean, is it just a better place, or what's the story?
No, Baranda is Madison Lane. It's right now has a really, really, really small self-haul, but we have seen an increase in from City of Salinas in the last 3 years.
Obviously.
Maybe what we need to do is a little bit more marketing from those districts where we don't have a presence.
Thank you.
Our attorney.
Madam Mayor, thank you. I just wanted to follow up on the question from Councilmember McShane. I think we might be confusing apples and oranges a little bit. The transfer station involves collaboration with Waste Management, and that's one place where that's working. And a broader question is the countywide Waste Management system, and there have been periodic requests to review whether that countywide system should be consolidated. Mm-hmm. And that's a complex question. It involves a lot of financial analysis. That involves the debt that some parties have. It involves things like what's the voting system if you're going to combine all these different communities together? How are they represented, and that kind of thing? And I believe that the authority did receive some kind of a report on that previously, and perhaps it would be helpful for you, council member, really anyone on the council who might be interested in this, to get a copy of that report, or even to meet with the staff from the authority to get a little more information.
Just seeing the report would, I think, be sufficient. Thank you. That clarification was important, because there are the both of them, and they're both out near Madison Lane, right? I mean, isn't there the countywide system obviously is feeding into the Monterey Regional?
Well, the big Waste Management landfill is out in Marina. Not Madison Lane.
Yeah. Okay. And so Madison Lane is merely a transfer station.
Correct.
Okay, got it. Okay, thank you.
Okay. I'll also extend an invitation to each of you to visit the site, and also provide you more detailed information on any of the questions report issues in the report.
Mr. Gamboa, thank you. Thank you for the report. And let me just preface everything that I'm going to ask you about. As you said, there's been a lot of expanded services to the community and to residents, and some of them are pretty impressive. As you drive through and you drop off a whole bunch of stuff, that's really pretty good how that whole process happens. My question is, and the concern of a lot of people is, and if you can talk about it, is how is the authority mitigating issues like the birds going into other businesses, the traffic, the trucks, the leakage from the vehicles, the smell, and then more importantly about the hazardous waste and how did that come about that initially was not a, and that's where I need you to help me talk about that, was initially the place authorized to handle hazardous materials, and if it did or if it didn't, how did that evolve? So lots of questions in there. So if you can talk about, because I know you've done some mitigation and work with the business, because that's the whole issue about being a good neighbor, being in a district where there's a lot of activity, a lot of people, and the concerns they have about the authority.
Well, the most challenging one, obviously, is the household hazardous waste because of the impacts. It is managed by staff that is fully trained, and they need, and again, we comply with all state regulation, including a local regulation through Monterey County. So we do have a permit to operate the household hazardous waste facility. The material is processed and packaged and ready for, once we have a load, then it leaves the site. So we keep a very minimal volume on site. Incidentally, the majority of the household hazardous waste that we receive is paint, and that paint is then recycled or used for the graffiti abatement, not only in the city of Salinas, but also in the rest of the community of the valley. So that's a good reuse. So that's managed well, and it is supervised by the agencies under very strict requirements. So regarding the birds, we have taken a proactive action, especially because one of our businesses, Sal Jimenez, was very concerned, and he and I talked, and so I told him that we were going to take an action, and we did. He emailed me just a couple of days ago, telling me that he was pleased that the bird problem was gone away. We're talking seagulls, so that's done. Regarding the odors, we move the trash rapidly. We keep a very, very small amount, and so any trash that may have some more organic matter or participable material leaves the site within less than 24 hours. So that keeps the odors problem under control.
So under traffic, I know that
regarding regarding the traffic, right now we're averaging about 140 vehicles or so a day. That's a low volume compared to our initial mitigated study did. The number of trucks that are coming out of our transfer station is 14 trips a day, 14 trucks leave the site a day. That's the three trucks an hour. One truck leaving and another truck coming back. That's three trucks an hour.
Okay. So just on the traffic, I know that you're talking short term to reroute or try to establish two ways to come into that area. Is when do you see that coming up online, and how are you going to ensure that people actually follow that route and really just go through that? Because I think there's a whole issue that where people try to find it convenient to get to your place, and I'm speaking of your truck or the trucks, and how we're going to manage that.
Yeah, our trucks follow Sun Street, which is a very narrow street, and then they have to make a turn on Commercial, which is also a very narrow street, and then from Commercial to Griffin, and then from Griffin to Market. So what we are proposing is that instead they use our back gate on Griffin, and instead they would use Griffin to Market. So that would reduce the traffic in that Sun Street Sun Street to Commission, excuse me, a street by 100%.
So in regards to making sure the drivers follow that, are you going to GPS the vehicles? I mean, because one thing is what you tell them, and another thing is what they're going to do and try to figure out a shortcut to get to the place.
No, our drivers are supervised.
Okay.
So there is the progressive discipline process. Yeah.
And I raised the GPS part of it because I know Monterey Salinas Transit has vehicles with GPS tracking, and they're able to tell in case somebody complains. And the reason I'm asking you all these questions, because these questions have been asked of me. And so that's why I'm asking you about some of the stuff, because, you know, obviously there's perception, but perception is reality to the person that sees it. And so just wanted, so what about the leakage from vehicles? As they're traveling from and delivering garbage.
Well, if we have a wet load, because it gets mixed with many other dry materials, that moisture gets diluted. But so far, unless there is a heavy, very heavy, heavy rain, we've experienced very little leakage. That but problem. What I will do is go back and look at the trucks to see about the seal. Regarding, again, our drivers adhering to a traffic pattern, I have full confidence. Our staff performs excellent. As you saw on our records, 3 years driving to Sun Street without any accident. We have excellent workers.
Thank you.
To my right. Okay. Take it out to the public. Any questions from the public on this matter?
Hi, my name is David Brown. I'm the past president of SUBA. Most of you were on the council whenever we were promised 2 years the transfer station would be gone. We went through why they didn't need to expand, why they couldn't have any more tonnage than they have now. We all agreed that it wasn't going to grow any bigger than it was, and it was going to be moved right away. And if SUBA would back off and let the process take care of itself. I wish we had more people like Tom working for us, because I could feel like people were being more honest with us. But the way it's worked out, honesty has been something that we haven't really had much of. We have children that play over there. We have a school that's over there. We have businesses that run out of there. We have seagull problems. We have smell problems. We have every kind of problem you could think of. Our businesses are all down because of this, which makes your revenue down. If you allow them to expand where they're at right now, they'll expand again, and they'll expand again. Somewhere along the line, this council has to draw a line and say enough's enough. Mr. McShane, we went through looking at both possibilities of two authorities or one authority. We actually went out and talked to all the supervisors, all the council members at the time, went out to Madison, went out to Marina Transfer Station, looked at all the facilities, how they were run, how they could be put together, and the Waste Authority stopped us from pursuing any further with that. So what I am hearing here, I don't like any of what I'm hearing at all. They're talking about putting a biodiesel tank in. When biodiesel catches fire, it doesn't catch fire as quick as diesel fuel does. But when it does catch fire, you have to smother it. It doesn't just put itself out. They can't just put it out because it'll flame back up again. I'm hearing talk of tanks that are going to be compressed natural gas that they're going to be using over there. That area does not need no more hazard over there. We have to get rid of the hazard that's there, and I look to this council to take the steps that need to be done and quit playing the political games that have been played prior to this. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Frank Yassin. I own 4 commercial properties on Market Street, like one block around from, or 2 blocks from the waste management. The first thing, when there's a little breeze at nighttime, you can smell. The smell comes all the way, like where Boya Loco is, where we're at. The birds haven't changed. We used to wash our cars once a week. We have to wash them every day because of the poop of the birds on the cars. I've been there for 17 years. I never seen rats. There's rats around on the street. I think that comes from there. I mean, we never seen them before. And the main thing we have is a traffic problem. Like when we have the trucks coming from Market, make a left turn on Griffin. You know, sometimes the light changed 3 times before the truck make that left turn. Because when the trucks are standing on the corner of Griffin on Market, they have to back up back to make the trucks to make that left turn over there on Griffin. And in the last year and a half, 3 of the trucks, the waste management trucks, hit our own customers' cars parked on Griffin Street. When they make that left turn, the corner of the truck hits our trucks. Thank you very much.
Anyone else on this matter?
I just want to say I'm probably the biggest customer for the Waste Authority and the use of the transfer station, and I can attest to the fact and back up what Mr. Gamboa said, that it is run safe, it is run efficiently, and it helps out everybody in the community, especially me. And if there's one thing that we could do I think anybody that's been on the Waste Authority Board knows and have heard me that hours of 8 to 5 are great for banks, but they're lousy for garbage companies. The early hours, especially for us at the transfer station, will really help out.